This is Mark Minarik. I'm here at the 2014 NAMM show with the Tone King, and we are going to be looking at some of the feature models here at the show. Behind me I have the St. Michael Slaying the Demon acoustic. Very edgy design, something you usually don't see on acoustic guitars, but you're seeing it here on the Minarik. It's a high-end guitar starting from the headstock. We have St. Michael smoting the demon, grabbing onto snakes. That's part of the theme of the guitar. Cool design point on this. We actually have the truss rod cover as part of the inlay, and not laying on top, but laying flush. It carries his feet down through the fretboard. So eliminating the whole, the nut being in the way of the design, we incorporate it into it. Following it down, the demon being smote in different positions, and we come to the payoff. The sound hole is a ribbon vortex of snakes, and this demon is being sucked down the sound hole, grabbing onto the snakes, pulling them out of position, trying to keep from getting sent back down to hell. So it's definitely a showstopper. Now, another thing, it might be difficult to see, but when we were assembling the guitar, there's skulls inlaid at the back, inside the guitar, down at the bottom of the pit. And if you can get in there with a camera, you might be able to see the skull face. Ah, there it is. And we hid that in there as we were building the guitar. I can see it through there. There we go, there he is. We have just a bunch of cool little Easter eggs hidden on this guitar. Nice. German spruce, Brazilian rosewood, the back and side. I'm gonna flip this around. The wood on this guitar is just stunning, with a sap marking, Brazilian rosewood neck with a maple maple strip. It's just fabulous. We love to do acoustics, and we kind of only do them one way, over the top. So I'm going to jump over to an electric before we get to the next acoustic. This is a Witch's Brew Firebolt. This is the first Firebolt we've done that has an arch top and a hollow body. We did the German car following the edge of it. A spectacular ocean burst paint job on this. This is one of the best. It just glows. The Witch's Brew inlay are three witches, redhead, blonde, and brunette, going about their craft. And it's a pictorial scene starting from the top. You have a redhead dropping a rat into the cauldron from up above. The rat is actually part of the truss rod cover. Again, it's flush and part of the inlay, kind of going through the nut of the guitar, incorporating that as part of the inlay instead of stopping it. You've got a beautiful scene with a cat on the a Baroque window ledge looking out at the full moon, bricks. You've got the two other witches adding ingredients into the boiling cauldron at the bottom. Super fun inlay, beautiful colors, recon stone, woods, and pearls. Definitely something that's been photographed quite a bit at this show. So we're really proud of that, and of course, you know the Firebolt sonically is one of the most amazing guitars that we build. So it's just an absolute tone machine. And it's ecstatic. Let me flip this on the back. We did a wood sandwich on this as well. We put a Purple Heart stripe, capped with maple to help it stand out. It's beautiful, and also adds some rigidity to the neck and body neck through. So we're really proud of this, and it's been quite a hit at the show. And lastly, I'd like to show you the Alice in Wonderland 12 string. Talk about over the top. This guitar is it. It's a complete pictorial of the original style artwork of Alice in Wonderland. You got Alice with the cards, and the truss rod cover is the Drink Me bottle, if you're familiar with that from the storybook. You've got the keys, cards, and all of the characters, the pocket watch, the cat, everything is represented on this fretboard. The payoff is the sound hole. You've got the hearts wrapped around in a traditional-esque sound hole, and we did a giant inlay of Alice jumping out of the sound hole, chasing a rabbit down the hole. We've got the all the characters represented on the fringes of the guitar. You can see here by the armrest, we've actually inlaid it, and it actually is cutting across quite a steep armrest. That's tricky to do on inlay and not end up having an edge showing. Beautiful bear claw spruce. I don't know if you can see the claw markings in the top, but that's a very beautiful fine piece of wood. I'm gonna flip this around. It's a koa back and sides, and more of the characters inlaid on the back of the guitar. A chocolate koa neck with a maple neck through. And of course, like the other acoustic, it's a full D45 style abalone on every glue seam. So this is absolutely beautiful presentation guitars. And again, very photographed at this show, and very proud to show it off. And we're always happy to have the Tone King here to take a look at what we have. And we hope you enjoy watching the Tone King production as much as we do taping it. And thank you for taking a look at us at the 2014 NAMM Show.